Welcome back, everyone. I'm Tanya Fitzpatrick, one half of the award-winning podcast World Footprints. The other half, my husband Ian, is taking care of other business, and we're practicing a little bit of social distancing right now. But today we are connecting with someone in Holland. In fact, he is the son-in-law of Johannes Sims from South Africa, who I recently interviewed. I'd like to introduce Merijn Martens from Holland. Merijn, thank you so much for joining me on this podcast, this video cast.
Welcome.
So your father-in-law told me something very surprising. He told me that Holland is in very poor shape with this coronavirus.
Yes.
And I found that surprising because we have not heard any news about Holland here in this country. So what can you tell us about the status right now?
At the moment, we have on IC, like 1,300 people, but the hospitals are full. I think we have now 8,000 registered people that are sick, but it's going up, and the statistics are not very good because we don't test a lot. We only test the people who say they have a fever, but they don't test family members or people related to them or who they were in contact with. So I think the real numbers are much higher than they're giving out for now. And the deaths are, I think, how many? Yeah, today there were 148. Well, I think it also more than 1,000 deaths already.
So I find it surprising. You told me that you're still able to go to work despite the spread of this virus and the number of people you have in intensive care.
Yes. Yes, we still, but it's all restricted. So because a lot of people at our company work from home. So I don't come in contact directly with other people. I'm sitting, I'm the only one at my office that's working. So I don't have people around me. We have some mechanics working, but everything is put to a minimum just to keep things a bit running, but not just the necessary things.
Mm-hmm. Do the medical professionals have enough supplies, or are they concerned with getting the virus as well?
The supplies are especially the mouthpieces,
the mask.
Yeah, the mask are short. And we had a stash from China that came in a few million, but they were rejected because they were not sufficient enough, good enough, the quality. So there's a shortage of that, but that's the main problem. And the tests, testing is very difficult.
Are tests allowed for people who may think they have the virus?
Yeah. And especially for the people who got the symptoms, or like a few symptoms, like a fever, coughing, and things like that. If you have those symptoms, then you will get the test. Then you can, the house doctor will send you to the hospital for testing.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why only the people with symptoms get tested, and I feel the real numbers of people infected are much higher than the few thousand they say now.
And I see you have little children in your home.
Yes.
And so how have you been able to cope with your little ones not being in school?
Yes, it's we have to home teaching, homeschooling. And yeah, it's a lot through internet, and the smallest one was going to crash, so it's she didn't have any work to do at home. But the oldest one, it's like 2 hours a day.
Mm-hmm.
And especially I'm still working, so my wife does all those chores with her. So but it's going well, but they're getting bored and they want to go to school, and see, they can play a lot with their friends, and so it's a bit difficult, especially the longer it takes.
Yes. Can they go outside, your front yard maybe, and play, or your garden?
Yes, that's allowed. They can't go outside, but it's not, yeah. Especially for the children, they say the harm, it's not, how do you say that? So very harmful as for the elderly people. Mm-hmm. So they say children can play, but not too much and not too far, especially the, and yeah, also like, so we have to keep a distance from adults from 1.5 meters.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And yeah, a lot of measurements. And also in the shops, we need to walk with a trolley, keep a distance. Only a certain amount of people are allowed in. So there are a lot of rules.
Okay. But people don't have masks. I'm thinking no, because medical professionals don't have sufficient.
Yeah, we have, you see a lot of people with the mask they use for working. So with the white ones, with the air breathers that you can buy by the lumber store, right? Mm-hmm. But not the surgical masks. And they wear a lot of gloves and and sanitizer, things like that they use.
Mm-hmm. And so because this is a global crisis, many people, many communities around the world are coming together and sharing acts of kindness or experiencing acts of kindness. What acts are you seeing in your neighborhood, in your community?
The teddy bear, yeah, they place teddy bears in front of the windows so people can, when they have a walk, they can count that. We have Stichting Present, what 18 now?
Yeah, they are.
My wife is also here, she's...
Well, the elderly, the children make...
Drawings, yes.
Like drawings, and then they take it for posts, so they're not in contact with
the elderly.
With the elderly. Because it's mostly the elderly in Holland that gets infected, yeah.
Hmm.
So they make drawings for the elderly people,
yes.
And give them as gifts?
Yes, because they're alone, sitting at home. They
yes.
post the drawings. So they have a light of the day, so can be happy that they have something and keep them busy.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yes.
So, Merijn, when the pandemic has lifted, mm-hmm. what will you do? What will you and your family do the moment it's lifted?
I think throw a party with a lot of people.
Can I come?
Yeah, you're invited. Always welcome. So, no, because that's also restricted. You cannot invite people at your home. You can only have like 3 people, but you need to keep your distance. If the police sees you're violating that, they will fine you. You get a 400 euros fine. It's almost $450 or something.
Yes.
And for companies, it's even more, up to 4,000 euros if you violate the rules.
So companies can't have more than a few people in their offices and they'll
yes.
be fined?
If you can keep your distance of 1.5 meters, then it's allowed. But
okay.
if you can work from home, you have to work from home.
Okay. Yeah. And how do you maintain your sanity? With the children at home all the time and you're pretty much at home, how do you stay happy?
Yes, yeah, I go work.
Okay.
So I can block myself, but it's difficult. It's
you have to print it in their minds.
Yeah.
wash your hands.
Yeah, but also how your sanity.
Just
tell yourself it's only temporary.
Right.
Also important, and make the best of it. And we are lucky that my mother-in-law is here, so we have some hands. If it's too much for us, we can give it to her and she will take over the children, so we have a little bit of peace and quiet. So it works well together.
I can imagine that it's for elderly people that can be very lonely.
Yes.
His father is single and alone. And he came here this afternoon and he stood in front of the window. So we waved and he said he doesn't like this anymore because he can't hug them, he can't kiss them.
And we have a newborn of 4 weeks old.
Bless.
So it's very difficult.
So he can hold his grandson, like my mother also. She lives like 20 minutes from here with my stepfather. But yeah, we cannot. We didn't see her from the epidemic happens. They are in the, especially their age, they're older. So they're, how do you say that? The risk is high for them.
Yes. Well, you guys be well. It's so lovely to see you. We're Facebook friends, but this is our first time talking and seeing each other. But thank you so much for sharing your story and for letting me say hello to Rachel, who I love, and for meeting your children.
Yes, you're welcome.
Thank you. Be well, be safe, and I hope to attend your party very soon.
Can't wait.
Stay safe too.
Yes.
Thank you.